Hi Aries, I'm Anisha. You can visit me at www.tarotbyanisha.com, and this is your monthly forecast for April 2012. Aries, we have a beautiful planetary lineup for you this month. It's a lovely month for you. We start this month with Sun, that is there in most of the half of the month in your first sign, and it's going to be bringing its brightness, its cheer, its clarity along with it. A lot of you are going to be paying attention to things that make you happy, things that are closest to you, your personal goals, your desires. What is it that makes you unique? What is it that makes you move? What is it that you desire from your work, from your personal space? So this is a lot of focus till about 19th. You're going to be examining these things very closely. And with Sun being there, it's a positive thing. You are going to be quite happy doing so. And for those of you who are looking for new opportunities, business opportunities, are going to be evaluating as to what is it that you bring to the table in whichever part of an organization or a partnership that you're going to be associated with. So it's a great time to be internalizing. It's a great time to be polishing your outer self for the world to see. So it's a good month for you, a good start. On the 4th, we have the magnificent messenger Mercury that goes direct. And Mercury is going to be bringing all its communication benefits along with it. So all the correspondence that has been stalling till now, or it has just been, you know, you've been waiting for people to respond and you've been waiting for some deals to close since January. You start hearing from them. There's going to be some amount of a momentum right now happening in your communication. You will be able to communicate also far more effectively. So wherein, you know, you may have been sitting and thinking that, you know, it's just become a stagnant case. There is really no worth in re-looking at that issue. This is the time you can actually pick up those loose ends and you'll be able to sort them. Your ruling planet Mars goes direct on the 14th, and thank God for that. You're going to be feeling the energy in full force. It's going to be making you very perky. It's going to be making you quite happy. It's going to be all the sluggishness of the last month, all the just a sense of wandering around and moving without any focus is going to clear for you. A lot of you will be starting out a new health regime, a new diet maybe. It's a great time, Aries, to get out there and do things that you really love doing, especially on the exercising and on the outdoorsy bit for you. It's also a great time for you to be picking up projects that may have got left off end of Jan, first week of Feb, to try and see whether they can be closed. It's a great time because they will in most likelihood close for you. There is a beautiful full moon on the 6th in Libra, and a lot of you are going to be putting your closest relationships under scanner. It's a great time to be acknowledging, accepting and transforming what it is and what can be done about it. And I will be discussing and reviewing this at great length in my love and relationship video. There is a lot of focus on your sixth house as well. That is your day-to-day chores, your mundane work. It's quite a boring house really, but with Mars coming and giving its energy out there, you're going to be more focused, you're going to get more organized, you're going to be looking at nitty-gritty details more carefully. So it's a good time for those of you also who are thinking of renovating, doing small fixes around the house. Even for some of you looking at moving houses, it's a great time to be researching, meeting up with agents, and it also covers people whom you employ, not just at work but also at home. So for those of you who have been looking for a good babysitter, it's a great time. You will be able to find someone who's efficient and loyal. The tarot message for you this month, Aries, is to get in touch with the child inside you. It's very, very important for you this month to do things that make you happy. So whether it is kicking off the shoes and walking bare feet in the garden, whether it is plugging your headphones and going for that lovely run on the beach, whether it is just going for a jog in the park with your dog, do all the things that make you childlike, that make you feel happy. Go back to the roots. Think, what is it that makes you feel happy? So have a lovely April. I'll see you again in May. And thank you so much for watching.